If your Canva account is in pure chaos, then you're wasting a ton of time and not designing as quickly as you could. You're scrambling to find a project you created a few weeks ago, can't seem to locate that one photo you uploaded, and constantly miss graphics that could have been posted on your socials already. Seems familiar? Well, it stops today. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people, it's Natalia and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. In today's Canva tutorial, I'll show you how to organize your Canva account step by step to stop wasting time, design quickly, and stop feeling overwhelmed. I've got 5 super simple Canva tips that are bound to keep your account clutter-free. Let's go. Step number 1, naming designs. The most important habit you can build to tame the chaos in Canva is to start naming your designs. And listen, I get it. You create a new design quickly, you open up a template, and the design name is the last thing on your mind. But this is step 1 to creating a huge mess and actually losing time when designing. When you name your designs, you can easily search through projects either from the homepage or while you're in the editor. Whenever you need to reference something quickly, add a previously designed graphic, or completely reuse an earlier design without having to start from scratch, naming is the best way to do it quickly. Without it, you're forced to scroll and scroll through hundreds of similar looking designs. My pro tip here is to use naming conventions for all of your designs. Since the majority of my designs are for social media and my YouTube tutorials, I always start with the name of the platform and a graphic type like Instagram carousel or YouTube B-roll. If you're designing for clients, you can use something like a client's name, project description, and some other category like a date. When you're part of a team, it's super important to communicate those naming conventions clearly so that everyone follows the same pattern each time. The same should apply to your files. Unless you have them properly named, you won't be able to search easily. Make sure everything you upload is titled using keywords you can remember. If you already have a bunch of untitled files, just change them from within your Canva account. Now, the next step is step number 2, creating folders. The best way to finally get organized within Canva is to create a folder system to hold all of your crucial assets and designs. Here, the rule is pretty simple. Create a structure that matches how you mentally organize things. If you already have a file system in place on your computer or in your project management tool, you could follow a similar hierarchy within your Canva folders so that it's even easier to maneuver for you. This is what this structure looks like for me. I've got all of my crucial brand assets like photos, elements, and core brand design stored there. I have my social media folder with all the different platforms I create for, as well as my products, my clients, and so many others. The great part about Canva is that you can create folders with subfolders, and then store all of the different types of assets there, like your designs, photos, graphics, videos, or brand templates. To move a design into a folder, you can either select it from the Projects tab on the homepage, click the 3 dots, and move to folder from there, or better yet, do it straight away from within the editor. Click Share, More, and then Save to Folder. Adding this step to your workflow each time you create a design is such a simple way to keep your Canva organized. When your Canva account is in a whole lot of mess right now, bulk moving is the way to go since you can select multiple files at once to send them to a specific folder. As a Canva free user, you can keep up to 200 designs in each, and for Canva Pro, folders can hold up to 1,000 designs. Step number 3, clearing up uploads. If your Canva uploads tab looks like this, then you're doing it wrong. Sure, it's fine to keep multiple files there while designing. If you're on a free account, retaining your most used assets and the uploads can make sense, but you're still better off keeping them elsewhere. For pro accounts, I'd argue that there's a much better way, more on that in just a moment. But if every time you want something from the uploads, you end up scrolling to find things, you're wasting time. Worse yet, and I've been guilty of this too, you sometimes forget that a photo or a video is already in your account and you have unnecessary duplicates there that waste your precious storage space. Instead, all of your uploaded files should eventually end up in a relevant folder. This way, you always know how to quickly access them from the Projects tab, which should be your command post for your entire Canva account. Not only can you apply any of your previous designs to a new one that you're working on, but it's also super easy to search for anything or go to specific folders. And if you want to browse and scroll the messy upload style, by all means, have at it using the images or the videos tabs. Organizing your uploads is so simple too. You can bulk select the files in there and move them to a folder of your choice. So much cleaner, and it usually has the power to speed up your designing workflow. Now, if you want to master Canva, make sure you sign up on the waitlist for my upcoming Canva course for beginners. You'll learn how to create beautiful and engaging designs for your social media and business, so you can't miss this one. Step number four, saving your brand. But what if you do want to quickly add your brand assets to a design? Wouldn't it make sense to just keep them in the uploads? Nope, they belong in your brand kit. As a pro user, all of your crucial brand elements belong in one place because there's no better way to keep a consistent brand image and design quickly. Here's how to quickly set up your brand kit. You can go to the Canva homepage, open Brand Hub, and click Add New. Give it a name and start uploading your assets. When you add a logo, Canva automatically suggests a new color palette, or you can add yours manually below using hex codes or the color tool. Add your fonts, two or three are absolutely fine, and you can upload yours from here if it's not in the Canva library. Just make sure you have the right to use it though. Next, upload your key brand photos, your graphics, and icons, and voila, you're all set. Staying on brand is so easy because you have access to all of it from the left tab in the editor. If you want to try Canva Pro for free for 45 days, head on over to the description box and claim it now. As a Canva verified expert, I can offer you 6 whole weeks instead of the standard 4, which gives you more time to check out the awesome features and see if they're right for you. So check out the link below. Don't have a Canva Pro account, but want to have something similar to a brand kit, create a folder and upload or move all of the most important brand assets there, including an image of your color palette so that you can quickly pick your brand colors. You can also create a design with your brand board, keeping all your favorite brand elements saved in one place, including fonts, logos, elements, icons, graphics, and images. Not only does it serve as your brand guidelines document, but you can also quickly pull it up from the projects tab in just a moment. Is it as convenient as a brand kit? Of course not, but it's still a great alternative to still stay organized and keep your brand image consistent across the board. Step number five, starring elements. Hopefully by now you know how to tame the chaos within your files, designs, and brand assets. But how about those favorite elements from the Canva library that you always come back to? Well, easy. Star everything you use consistently and come back to. This works for templates, graphics, stickers, shapes, and photos, but unfortunately, it cannot be done for videos and audio. What I love about it is that when you star an element, a new tab appears in the editor where you can just quickly grab your favorites. For me, it's like an inspiration board constantly reminding me of visually interesting elements that spark some new ideas for a design. To star something from the canvas, just select an element, go to Eye in the top panel, and star. Within the library, just click the three dots and star from there. You can do the same thing with templates from the design tab or the templates tab on the homepage. Super useful when you're just browsing and randomly find something you really like. One of my favorite tips I've shared is to star the works of your favorite creators on the app. This way, you'll be able to quickly access their profiles and browse or search for more elements of the same style. You can also create a special folder for your favorite asset, which will work for videos too. I've shared this hack in my very first Canva Tips and Tricks video, so if you want to know more awesome tricks to design more quickly and do new cool things in Canva, make sure you watch it next. I've got so many amazing videos to help you become a better designer and grow your social media, so hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell to not miss any upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoy this one. Have an amazing day, and I'll see you next time.